Welcome to another RealVolve training video. In this segment, we're going to cover workflow packages, what a workflow package is, and how to create them. To do so, we're going to go under the Settings section, click on the drop-down, choose Settings. This brings you into your Settings area. And off to the left, we have this Workflow and Template Packages. This is where you can build your workflow packages. Clicking on the blue plus allows us to create a new workflow package. We'll enter the name of that workflow package. I'm just going to type in the name My Package. You can put in information about that package as far as a full detailed description. You can type in really anything that you want and include as much information or as little information as you like. The first thing that you want to do is decide what kind of type of package is this. Is this going to be a premium package where a code is required, or is it going to be a public package? To begin with, I'm just going to choose public to make it available to everybody. You'll want to put in your name, your address information if you want that published, your email address, as well as phone number and website if you like that information to be public. It can be a link to more detailed information from your website to that package. An image can be assigned to this so that it looks nice in the library. The image does require to be 180 pixels by 240 pixels. That's 180 wide by 240 high. So once you have the information that you want in here, you can click on Save. Once it's saved, it then gives you the ability to start adding the workflows and the templates to your system. Now I can click on the blue plus over here to the right, and it will load up what templates and workflows that you have available. Now I've got a lot of workflows and a lot of templates in my system just because this is where I put everything together. We've also got a lot of the libraries for other systems in here. But you, what one thing that you can do is whenever you're creating workflows, each workflow activity has the ability to have templates built in. So if you come to your workflows and you check off certain workflows that you want to have included, whenever you save those items, we're going to add these two workflows to this sample package. I'm going to click on the Save button. By choosing the workflows first, it goes ahead and adds those workflows, but then it also goes through each of those workflows and figures out which ones have templates and automatically includes those. If, however, they're not, if you've just got templates, you don't have workflows that go along with them that pre-selects them, you'll want to go ahead and select the templates. Again, just by clicking the plus next to the workflows and templates area, and then going in and selecting the different templates that you may want. Once you've got them, then you can click on the Save button. Once you have everything laid out, you've got your workflows, your templates defined, once you've got your descriptions and all the pertinent information that you want to have supplied whenever you go to the library, you can check this little checkbox here and then click on Save. What this does is this will send us an email to approve this package. Now, we do go through the package, we take a look at it, make sure that the information is consistent, that you've got necessary information, and make it valid for other users to be able to import from the library. Once your workflow has been approved, you should be able to go into the workflows area, click on the blue plus, choose Add Workflows from Library, and click on Continue. If your package has been approved, it will be listed in this list. And the package that we just added, I have not approved it yet, so it's not in the list. But once it is in the list, it would be similar to this Integrity Team workflow. It would have the basic detailed descriptions, any kind of image, if the image was supplied, the ability to rate that package. It will also tell you how many workflows and how many templates are in that different package, and the detailed information of who is the provider of that package. You can then click on the install. If it's a public package, it will install automatically. Otherwise, if it is a premium one, it will require a code similar to this, where you can type in a code and install it. Now, one thing that I did not show is how to deal with premium packages. So I'm going to go back to our settings, go back to the workflows and templates, And we're going to go back to the My package. Now you will probably only have, you know, the one in there. You won't see all of these other packages because these are mine. Go to the My package, which I just created. And you'll see that there is the type. It's still public. I'm going to change it to premium. Now what this does is this takes the package and makes it so that it's only available based off of a code. So I'm going to, once you click on save and you saved it, that it's going to be a premium package, a new area opens up here for code. I can click on the blue button to create additional codes. And in here, we have the ability to create codes either as a single use or an unlimited use. So say, for instance, I want to create a single use installation code, meaning it can only be used one time. I can tell how many single uses I want to create. I may want to create 5 single use installs. And click on add. It takes a few seconds for them to show up. I just clicked on the save to refresh it and it comes up. Here in the code section, you'll see that there are 5 codes now available. They're all single use codes. And over here on the right hand side, it shows you the links for who installed it. In this case, nobody has installed these workflows yet, so it just says NA for not available. A single use code can be installed one time. So anytime that this particular code is used, that's used up. It will no longer be available. You also have the ability to create an unlimited use code. What we'll do is we'll create one unlimited and click on add. Now at this point, we have still our 5 single use codes, plus we have an unlimited one. So the difference here is singles can only be used one time. An unlimited code can be used forever. So basically what happens is you can have as many different people install using this particular code. Once you have your codes available and once your workflow package has been approved, then they can be used to install on other RealVolve users' systems. If you have additional questions, please email support@realvolve.com or visit our help desk. Have a great day.